interview Dr. Moya. For me, it's Dr. Moya. There's Dr.
Watsa.
Yes. And he's been a teacher, a pioneer. He's been working in intensive care for over 30 years. He's written book. He's created the Moya app. And his mission is to take away tears and turn them into happiness. So he want to give you all the tips to help you, especially for mothers like myself. He really wants you to stop running off to the doctors unnecessarily. He has he's done a book, Bring Tears of Happiness. He's dedicated himself to fighting infection of superbugs. And so he will tell you a bit more about what he actually do. And I'm sure you'll find it very informative and we'll be able to answer all your questions. You know, we're live, so we want you to share and make comments in the box. So make the best of it.
As Wendy said, I've been chasing the superbugs because I started seeing children die with infections which we cannot treat. I have dedicated myself for this cause because we have 12 bugs which we cannot treat in hospitals. It used to be only one MRSA 10 years ago when I started. And now we have 18 bacterias and viruses, fungus, TB, malaria, which have rapidly become resistant, which we cannot treat if you catch one. And the other most dangerous thing which is happening is gonococcus and syphilis. These are sexually transmitted disease which is spreading rapidly, which we cannot treat. This is going to affect all our children, especially the teenagers. And I'm very concerned about that because the infection, if it happens, the teenager is not going to discuss with you. And the app is the only opportunity in which we can communicate. So they don't have to be scared of coming and telling the mother that they had sexual encounter. And they can get the advice they need. And in that way, we can at least reduce the number of contacts and spread in the local community. I hope I made it very clear.
Yeah, I think you made it very clear. I think really on this platform, we want to discuss health and we want you as the public to really take control of your health. That's the whole point of these discussions. As you know, that our public health issues, and they are widely becoming problems and they're costing the NHS. So we just really want people to take control of their health and help themselves, because our health services are not coping and people are going to be able to rely less and less on the NHS. And so, you know, what would you like to say? It's the election time. For me, Jeremy Corbyn seemed to be the person who is talking more about the people who are less advantaged. And so there's certain policy that Jeremy Corbyn is been addressing. And for me, I've leaned more to Jeremy Corbyn. And rich are really concerned about themselves, and people in politics really are, especially the last coalition government, where we've seen they've slashed welfare, we've seen them, you know, anticipated the NHS. I mean, they've contracted out most of the services. So we're more becoming looking like private. We're not yet private, but most of the work are being contracted out to private contractors. These contractors are rich, big contractors, and at the end of the day, is it benefiting the public? We don't think so. And so Jeremy Corbyn is trying to you know, look out for people like me, you know, people at the bottom, people who are really trying in society. And I think people need to really listen and have an open mind and really look at the policy both parties are coming with, because at the end of the day, you know, there's a, I mean, Theresa May is continuing with the previous government. And at the end of the day, we want somebody new now. And I think it's time for Jeremy Corbyn. I know they're giving him a hard time, but I have to say, he is my front runner. And It is because I've been listening to some of the things that he's been saying he's going to do for the people. And I just hope that, you know, he's going to be putting in, especially in the deprived areas where people are not getting the full benefits of the welfare system. So people are being squeezed in education, people are being squeezed in health service, people have been squeezed in housing, in their benefits, disability benefit. And so they're all intertwined. We still have to look at policies if we're talking about health, because we need to be reducing the level of inequality in health to narrow the gap between rich and poor. Because the way they measure health in the richer area, people live longer than people who are living in the poorer areas. And we tend to take it for granted because we're living in England and we think that, you know, everything is a level playing field. It is not a level playing field. And so people has to be aware and take full control of their wealth. Do, you know, eat clean, try and get a bit of exercise in, drink a bit of water. These are all little tips people can do. And so that is why this platform, we want to talk health. We want to help you take control back of your health.
Yeah, Wendy, the thing is, the basic problem we have is the advisors to various governments. I don't only localize NHS as such, but I've seen various other governments as well. Everybody seems to be only concerned about having high-tech hospital. What is this high-tech hospital? Next 5 years, it'll probably be like a ghost town. Because whether it's a clean hospital or a dirty hospital, the infection rate seems to be going up. The reason is not because the dirty hospitals have got different bugs. It's the same bugs which is there present in the water, in the sand, in the environment, and in hospitals. The ones who clean the hospital using heavy chemicals seems to colonize more bacteria which we cannot treat. I mean, it's just common sense, really. In 2005, I wrote a letter to Tony Blair. Please do not clean the hospital. The reason is, if you want to catch six terrorists running around in the town center, do you think putting a bomb into that area to kill the terrorists will solve the problem? That's exactly what they did. They killed all the good germs and left the superbugs free time. They have multiplied like nobody's business. And they are colonizing in every sewer system, every toilet. And if you happen to go there, you get infected. And these infections cannot be treated. So the chances of you getting more superbug infections in cleaner hospital than the dirty hospitals. The other thing, yesterday, America routinely checks the TALs, which is sterilized, heat-treated. And they keep a monitor of the bacteria present in the sterilized towels which are sent to the hospitals, hotels, sports centers. And when they looked at it, they found the bacteria colonized after sterilization are resistant. So now just imagine you going to a hospital and they're giving you a bath and use this towel. They're in fact putting superbugs onto your body. So I am very passionately talking about it because I have seen people suffer who should have not been suffering and dying, and this is going to get worse. It's not going to go down. So my mission is to fight infections, save life, and I bring tears of happiness. People can't understand what it is all about. Tears of happiness is what I've seen for 30 years. After I tell the mother or the father or the patient that he is or she has come out of the critical situation, tears roll out of their eyes. Because they're so happy that they're getting better. The hope of living, that brings tears of joy. It is not joy, I say happiness. Because happiness is mental and physical well-being. Joy is just pleasure. This word has a significant meaning. And that's why people should understand happiness is what healthcare provides. We don't give prescriptions to cure anything. 30 years I can categorically say, I have not been able to cure anything because none of these illnesses experienced by the patient has any drug which cures anything. One and the only one which I have seen were the antibiotics, and that too, we have lost it now. In 30 years of my career as a doctor, I started off with two antibiotics. We had about 26 antibiotics, and now we have none. And that's a simply a disgrace. It is not because doctors are doing anything wrong. It's not because, but abusing antibiotic has been a major, major problem. And I think we have to address this issue. And only way we can do that is by education. I hope I'll be able to educate you and your friends and families. Please tell all your friends to come here and tell me what you want to know. And I'll share it with great pleasure. Thank you.
These will both be numb, and she'll always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come, but at least we'll both be beautiful and still worry about it. She told me don't worry no more. We both know we can't go without it. She told me you'll never be in love, but I love it. Oh, I can feel be the death of me. At least we'll both be numb, and she'll always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come. All the misery was necessary. Girl, I know. She told me don't work without it. She told me you'll never be in love. I can feel my face when I'm with you. But I love it. But I love it. Oh, I can feel my face.
And we thank you for sharing the video, and we'll look forward in doing this more often so we can add value to your life. All right, thank you, have a good day.